Hello guys, welcome back to Watch Time. Today's movie recap will be a comedy and family movie from 2011 called Monte, Carlo. Warning, there are spoilers ahead. The movie starts with Grace and her best friend Emma. Their dream is to graduate from college and visit Paris. To save money for this trip, they work as waitresses at a restaurant despite being teased by their friends. After graduation, Grace's family holds a small celebration at their home. The joy turns sour when Grace's parents announce that her stepsister Megan will join them on the Paris trip. Grace and Megan are not close, but they have to go together since the tickets have already been bought. Before leaving for Paris, Emma's boyfriend Owen proposes to her, hoping she'll stay. Emma accepts the proposal but insists on going to Paris, leading to a heated argument. Owen, frustrated, tells her to leave. The next day, the three girls arrive in Paris and start touring with a guide. Emma hurts her leg while climbing stairs, and a fellow tourist named Riley helps her, starting a connection. However, Meg rushes them away. That night, they are forced to share a small room. Though Meg complains, Grace suggests they make the best of it. The next morning, they visit the Eiffel Tower. Meg meets Riley again, and while they are enjoying the view, Grace sees their tour bus leaving through a telescope. They try to catch it but fail and end up stranded. Upset, Grace walks away, with Emma and Meg following. It starts raining as they head back to their hotel and they get soaked. They rush into a fancy hotel to dry off. Grace goes to the restroom to freshen up. Meanwhile, in the lobby, a local celebrity named Cordelia, who looks just like Grace, is having a conversation with the receptionist. Unable to find a restroom, Cordelia leaves. Emma and Meg are stunned by her resemblance to Grace. When Grace returns, Emma and Meg excitedly tell her about Cordelia, but Grace dismisses it. As they are about to leave the hotel, the manager mistakes Grace for Cordelia and offers her one of their best rooms and dinner. Confused but tempted by free food, Grace accepts. The girls are amazed by the luxury of the room. Meg warns against using someone else's identity, but the others ignore her and decide to rest, planning to leave once the rain stops. They all fall asleep and are awakened the next morning by a phone call. Grace answers and learns a car is waiting for her at the hotel entrance. With no other options, they get dressed and head downstairs. They meet the hotel manager again, who gives them a package and escorts them to a private car. Meg is still unsure about the situation, but the other girls convince her to come along. In the car, Emma opens the package and discovers they are going to a charity event in Monte Carlo. They then board a private jet and read an article about Cordelia in a magazine. In Monte Carlo, they are warmly welcomed by the charity event host and his son, Theo. Theo dislikes Cordelia, thinking she's spoiled, so he is cold to Grace. He tells her to prepare for a press conference related to the charity event and mentions she will auction one of her rare necklaces. The girls enter their hotel room, filled with Cordelia's dresses and high-end makeup. That evening, Grace, Emma, and Meg dress in designer clothes for the press conference. Grace wears an expensive necklace. At the event, Grace feels everyone's eyes on her. Theo explains the necklace is rare and is the highlight of the upcoming charity auction. Back in Texas, Owen tries to contact Emma to apologize, but he can't reach her because she left her phone in the hotel room. Desperate, he decides to go to Paris to find her. Meanwhile, Theo introduces Grace to his friend Dan and leaves them to talk. He then talks to Alicia, Cordelia's aunt. Alicia notices Grace's behavior seems different, more charming and happy, but Grace quickly changes the subject and walks away. The scene shifts to the beach, where the girls are having fun. When Emma teases Meg, she gets upset and walks away, running into Riley again. They start talking and seem to like each other. Riley says he's leaving for Italy the next day, but wants to spend time with her first. Meg, tired of the trip, agrees and leaves with him. Later, Grace is taken to Theo's house, where his father has organized a polo match between Cordelia and a skilled opponent. Grace doesn't know how to play polo and performs poorly. Her aunt Alicia, who is in the audience, becomes suspicious of Grace's identity and decides to call her nephew to confirm her doubts. Cordelia answers and says she's out of town, making Alicia suspect that Cordelia hired Grace to attend events for her. Later, while Grace is petting a horse, Alicia confronts her. Realizing there's no point in lying, Grace explains the whole situation. Alicia, though upset, agrees not to call security and suggests Grace continue pretending to be Cordelia until the charity event is over because she cares about the charity work. Theo takes Grace to one of his favorite places, and it's clear he has fallen for her due to her changed attitude. Meanwhile, Emma is picked up by Dan for a party. She wears a beautiful dress and a valuable necklace meant for the auction. At a traffic signal, she sees Meg on a scooter with Riley. They reconcile, and Meg asks Emma to keep the necklace safe, placing it in Riley's bag for now. Grace and Theo enjoy a fireworks display by the river, developing feelings for each other but are hesitant to confess. Meg and Riley sneak into a club and have fun dancing. Elsewhere, Owen sees a photo of Emma and the girls in a magazine and learns they are in Monte Carlo. He immediately sets off to find them. The next morning, Meg returns to the hotel with Riley and they share a kiss before parting. In the hotel room, Grace reads an article about Cordelia, learning the necklace is worth millions. Meg, realizing she left it in Riley's bag, rushes to the balcony but sees he has already left. She confesses everything to Emma and Grace, who scold her for being careless. Just then, they spot Cordelia arriving at the hotel. In a hurry, the three girls rush to their room and start rearranging their things. On her way to her room, Cordelia meets Theo, who greets her with a kiss, only to receive a hard slap in return, leaving him confused. Cordelia goes to her suite, and the girls have no chance to escape. They hide on the balcony edge and carefully make their way to a nearby terrace while Cordelia talks on the phone. The girls manage to reach the train station, but the train has already left. Anxious and upset, they decide to confess the truth to Cordelia and apologize for losing her necklace. Meanwhile, Cordelia sees a picture of the trio in a magazine and reads about the valuable necklace. She checks her luggage and, not finding the necklace, screams in anger. Riley arrives at the hotel's reception and asks for Meg's room number. At the same time, the receptionist answers Cordelia's phone, pleading with her not to involve the police. Feeling ignored, Riley takes the elevator and searches for Meg's room. Shortly after, Grace and her friends arrive, surprising the receptionist who thinks Grace is Cordelia. He offers security assistance, but she declines. Theo approaches Grace, suggesting she get ready for the auction. Grace kisses him and promises to meet him later, leaving Theo confused as he had been slapped by Cordelia earlier. The girls head to their room and find Riley in the hallway with the missing necklace. Meg hugs and thanks him for returning it. Owen arrives at the hotel and asks the receptionist for Emma's room number. The police enter the hotel, responding to Cordelia's report of her stolen necklace. Grace, Emma, and Meg decide to confess everything to Cordelia. They enter her room with the necklace and try to explain, but she refuses to listen and doesn't want to attend the charity auction. Upset, the girls abduct Cordelia and swap her with Grace just before the police enter. Grace, disguised as Cordelia, leaves for the auction. As Grace is escorted out, she spots Owen and Riley in the lobby. Meg accidentally reveals Emma's location, who is guarding Cordelia upstairs. Owen goes to Emma's room, apologizes for his past behavior, and confesses his love. Emma happily accepts his proposal. Meanwhile, Cordelia frees herself and rushes to the charity auction. At the auction, Grace becomes nervous, so Meg joins her on stage. They reveal the entire situation, stunning the audience. Cordelia arrives and demands the police arrest Grace for impersonation and theft. Theo, upset, leaves the room. Alicia enters the auction and bids 6 million euros for the necklace. Cordelia tries to stop her, but Alicia is determined to help Grace. The police tell Cordelia that there is no case since the necklace now belongs to someone else. After the event, Meg decides to go to Italy with Riley, Emma leaves with Owen, and Grace returns home alone. In the final scene, Meg and Riley travel the world, enjoying life. Emma and Owen have a special dinner, indicating they have resolved their problems. Grace volunteers at a school for children in Romania. While mailing letters at the post office, she sees Theo, who is there for a charity deal. He follows her and whistles to get her attention. The movie ends with them introducing themselves and shaking hands with a smile. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to give a thumbs up and subscribe. Take care and see you next time.